think I finally found mine. It's good to be alive right about now.
I'm assistant director of bands at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, and this is something we've called the Doug and Tony Show. We normally take it on the road to high schools, but this is an online version so that people outside of our area can view it. We love for people to follow us on Twitter or like us on Facebook. In fact, here are Twitter handles for the UNL Bands feed, and associate director of bands Tony Falcone and myself. If you'd like to schedule a time for the Doug and Tony Show to come to your school and we can make it from the Lincoln, Nebraska area, please send me an email at dbush2@unl.edu. This part one is really going to be all about who we are, kind of an introduction, and just talking a little bit about the benefits of being involved in music and band specifically. Director of bands is Dr. Carolyn Barber. She conducts the wind ensemble, teaches conducting, oversees the entire program. Associate Director of Bands is Tony Falcone. He's the director of the Cornhusker Marching Band, conducts the symphonic band, teaches instrumental arranging, and is also involved in the percussion studio. Here is my school day photo. Again, I'm Doug Bush, Assistant Director of Bands. I'm the Assistant Marching Band Director. I write all the drill for the Cornhusker Marching Band. Professor Falcone and I team teach that class together. I conduct the Big Red Express pep band that plays for basketball and volleyball. I conduct two campus bands that meet in the spring semester, supervise student teachers, and teach a couple of music ed courses. It sounds like I do more than the other two band directors, and that's because, well, I know more about what I do. Director of Jazz Studies and Professor of Saxophone is Dr. Pearl Haar. If you contact the band office for any reason, chances are you'll be talking to Rose Johnson or Jan Deaton. They really are the ones that make things happen. They tell us where we need to be, when we need to be there, what we need to wear, what we get to eat, all that good stuff. I'm going to take just a moment and remind everyone how special band is.
At least once in your life, it's important to be a part of something that is bigger than the sum of its parts.
The band is just such an entity.
The experience, those years of love and loss, joy and pain, play a critical role in the development of your perspective on our place in the universe.
To understand that there are things in life that are bigger than we are and that require the collective will of a number of people to be successful.
This is crucial to understanding life, that we are all dependent on each other. That individual success is sweet, but that greatness is achieved most often by standing on the shoulders of many who came before you, holding the hands of others who stand beside you.
And all that is to say that the kinds of lessons that we learn being involved in an ensemble, like band, choir, orchestra, are different kinds of lessons that we may learn in other classes. The fact that I work on my part and they bring that to rehearsal and then put it together with the collective ensemble, work with the other people that may be playing my part, and then also the people in my section, and then our section is coordinating with other sections, and many times sections that may be on the other side of the ensemble. So the kind of learning environment and dynamic that we have in an ensemble is much different than what we would have in, say, a science or a math class. They've done some students of high school students and learned high school students involved in music. And they learn some things. They learn that they have higher graduation rates. They have less substance abuse. They have a higher attendance rate. Having something that you're excited about at school to get you motivated to get up and get there in the morning is important. It may positively affect test scores and learning. We know that musicians' brains form differently. And then we already kind of talked about a little bit about preparing one for a successful life just because of the different learning environment. What do we have at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln as far as band goes? If you ask the average person on the street about the Nebraska band, chances are they will know about the marching band. They've seen us at a game. They've seen us in a television show. They've seen us in a movie. They know about us. But they might be surprised to know that we have four different concert bands. And then we have two full-size big bands that break out into combos. Sometimes high school students get in their mind that they're going to need to be a music major to be involved in music or be involved in band at the college level. And I would encourage all high school students to stay involved in music after high school, wherever you end up. But if you end up looking at UNL or you end up on our campus, I hope that you will look at the bands. All of our ensembles are open to all students, regardless of major. Some ensembles are required audition, some do not. In fact, the campus bands, both of them are open. Just enroll, show up once a week, play a concert. But it doesn't have anything to do with anyone's major. So you could be the lead trumpet player of the top jazz band and not be a music major. You could be drum major of the Cornhusker Marching Band and not be a music major. You could be the concert mistress of the orchestra and not be a music major. You can see here only about 20% of the students in a marching band are music majors. The next highest percentage of major, believe it or not, is engineering. If you've heard anything so far in the talk that you would like to get more information about, you can go to our website, first of all, and do research and find more about the band program than I've ever known. And you can fill out this form, and we will send you the information that you request. So if you'd like to know more about marching bands, athletic bands, concert bands, camps, clinics, we'll make sure that you get that information. And speaking of, this was part one. I'm hoping that I've piqued your interest enough that you might check out parts two, three, or four on the same YouTube channel. Part two is going to deal with marching band, the nature of the ensemble, and what it takes to be a member. Part three is going to deal with pep band, so basketball, volleyball, and then some other sports that we play for. Again, what it takes to be a member. And then part four is going to be all about things that high school students can do now to be connected to us and a part of our program. We offer lots of things for high school students. I hope that you enjoyed your time with me, and I hope to see you again real soon.